week. Gotta get the bag and racks every day. Don't tell me to relax, I can't, I'm a snake. Got a new press, those and the J's in the way. Got a new bitch, watch ready, don't take time. I pull up on the off if it's talking too hot. And you wanna play ball, hit a 3-point shot. Or this my court, got a block on lock.
I made about a million and I'm only 19. I see water dripping on a white tee. And shorty got a man, but she saying wife me. I got chest coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then you know I'm finna get it. Just do it. In the bag and then I flip it, watch me do it. Just do it. All them all on my wrist going stupid. Just do it. Tryna put them on, but they never do it. They're like, hold up, wait a minute, like don't make sense to really get it. I'm steady getting to the chicken, that tasty finger licking chicken. I mean, I'm getting to the good guap. Keep a rack in my socks. Diamonds cost me a lot. Nike check up all of my socks. Hey, hey yo, Nike check.
Of a yard.
24-yard line.
Ball at the 24 and a second and 11. Fake to mix it and now look to throw. That one taken in by T. Higgins. 4 yards on the completion and it sets up a third down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
A tough spot here on their opening drive. This is 3rd and 7. Now Burrow. Catch made here by Campbell. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. It'll wind up being a loss of 2. And that'll bring up 4th down. On is the punter Scott here as he gets this one away. This is taken at the 15. Very good return there. Give him an even 20 yards. And the Ravens, they'll take over. Good starting field position for them as they come up 1st and 10 at their 35-yard line. to throw. It's Mahomes. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. It'll be a gain of 6, and that'll make it second down.
6-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 4 at the 41-yard line.
From the gun, it's Mahomes. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he'll go out of bounds, it appears, right at the 45. 4 yards the pickup, first down. They run the option here on 1st and 10. Mahomes quickly complete out wide. And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. Nothing on that one. It'll be 2nd down.
Brings up 2nd and 10 at the 45-yard line.
Now it's Mahomes again. Eluding the pressure right. Now he'll pull it down. He'll end up getting 5 out of that, but now they're looking at 3rd down.
Now how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
A nickel look now for the Bengals as they try to stop him here on 3rd down. First carry for the former Buckeye, J.K. Dobbins. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. 3 yards won't be enough here as that'll bring up 4th down. And now the Bengal defense here calling a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. John Harbaugh going to roll the dice. They're going for it on 4th down. For it. It's Mahomes being chased out. Mahomes hit. He lost the football, and the Bengals grab it. A big seam, and he might go all the way. And this is taken into the end zone. A fumble recovery and a Cincinnati touchdown. And that's a linebacker showing he can move pretty good with a football in his hand.
That's not just a short shuttle now. He took it and went a pretty good distance, didn't he? Did you get the 40 time on that?
I didn't, but he got 6 points out of it. I know that, and a great play for that defensive unit. And he's got it to make it 7-0 Bengals.
Makes the score Bengals 7, Ravens nothing.
And you can bet they're preaching 2 hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. Taken about 7 yards deep. They're only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
At their own 19-yard line.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. First down, Mahomes. That's complete to his running back, J.K. Dobbins. He's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backside of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got my he just snuck out there and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on 1st down. Throws is going to be incomplete. Devin Duvernay, the intended receiver, and it's third down. And this pass defense, they were sensational in the win last week, and they're looking good here so far in this first quarter.
You know, we often talk about how offenses get locked in, and that runs over multiple games where they're really, you know, in that zone. Defenses can be the exact same way, and I think we're seeing an example of it here.
And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. He's able to chew up 8 yards on the carry there, but still, fourth down upcoming.
Fourth and short, partner. I mean, this would be a really risky call. Here we are in the first quarter.
On your own side of the field.
But boy, what a tone setter that would be to go for it and get it, wouldn't it?
You're gritty today. I like it.
I'm feeling it.
They'll run for it. It's Edwards. And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. They only needed a few inches, but still some anxious moments there. But they do convert on fourth. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. They'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. Mahomes gets it out quickly, and it's complete out wide. He's going to go out of bounds. But he takes this one down just shy of the 20. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain. That's how you draw up the run-pass option right there. You get a chunk play out of it.
And you know quarterbacks love to throw the RPOs because oftentimes they're in-breaking routes. But receivers love it even more. Ball gets to them quickly, allows them to put some moves on in the secondary.
Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side.
That's the end of the first quarter with the score, Bengals 7. Ravens nothing.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. Now here's Mahomes. This will be caught just inside the 10. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9.
Baltimore Ravens.
7 yards on the pickup there, and now they've got it first and goal. They'll try the option on first and goal. A quick throw complete into the flat out left. And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. Gus Edwards, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Ravens are an extra point away from tying the football game. Tucker able to connect on the extra point. And we are tied at 7.
Justin Tucker to kick off.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. The Bengals drive about to get going. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't come before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
A gain of a yard. Brings up third.
From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. And he's got a man. It's the tight end, Howard, complete. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. It's a Bengal first down, a pickup of 11. And this is going to be incomplete.
Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Midfield, he goes into Raven territory. That'll leave him with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
What a luxury to have a guy like this who can not only spell your starter, but can come in and keep drives going.
Elliott trying to work his way forward, but it looks like he did not make it. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down.
No gain on the play. It's now fourth down.
Fourth down. Here's Joe Burrow. Open man is Howard, the tight end. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. A solid pickup of five and a very solid fourth down conversion. And defensively, pure frustration. First down carry, and he stopped immediately there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. From the gun, a give to Mixon. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
Now the Bengals on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and 4. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. It's caught, Jones. And he is going to have a Bengals first down. He needed 5, he got it barely, as it will officially go down as a gain of 5 yards. Now a first down carry by Jones. He winds up getting only a couple there, down to the 29.
The ball carrier. He's tackled at the 29.
We've hit the 2-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up at 7.
Second and 8.
A reminder coming up just a few minutes from now. We'll send you to Jonathan Coachman and our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a look back at some of the stats and scores from yesterday's action. Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. It's an 8-yard pickup, and they'll be faced with a third and inches.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Third and inches, and they've got some extra beef up front. 3 tight ends. They'll try to run for it with Elliott. And he is going to have a Bengals first down, maybe by about a yard, as they find a way to convert on third and inches. Just a gain of a couple, but good enough to keep the drive rolling. Timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. From the shotgun, it's Burrow. That's caught by Howard. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9.
To O.J. Howard.
9 yards on the play there, and it'll set him up first and goal. They'll give it to Mixon. And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown.
On the carry.
Joe Mixon, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Bengals have taken the lead.
And that touchdown gives them a touchdown lead before they attempt the extra point. What a great way to end the half.
Yeah, great job to put themselves in front. And now, see on the sideline, special teams defense scrambling, saying we want to preserve this for the final moments of this second quarter. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game.
Makes the score Bengals 14, Ravens 7.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
5-yard line. The Ravens take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Inside of a minute left in the half, does the fact that you're down on the scoreboard influence what you do or, I guess, don't do on this final drive?
It certainly does, but what influences me even more is what I get running my football team out on the field and the weapons around him. Can he make a play? Can he get into someone that we're going to trust to take care of the ball? If that's the case, I might push it a little bit here and try and get something before the half runs out.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Buying time to his left. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. They go play action. Now Mahomes forced out to his left. It's complete to Brown, right side. Ravens going to use their third and final timeout as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime.
43-yard line.
On first and 10, here's Mahomes. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. Again, they'll throw with Mahomes. And he comes back with one complete. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals 28. Same result as last play, 14 yards and another first down. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. And now a timeout defensively after that first down play. So they're going to make this offense sweat out half number one. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. Spotted at the left hash, this from 45. And this one is right down the middle. And that will do it for this first half. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. It's in the game. The Ravens set to receive the football, trailing here as we resume action in the third quarter. Taken from about the 12. A lane opens here. He's past the 30. And all in all, a pretty solid return. Nearly got it to the 35. They'll mark him down officially at the 34. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively, just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to. How did each play work? Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back to some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. On second down, here's the option. Quickly completed to the right flank. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. A gain of 28 yards there and give him a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. This game not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two. You can just kind of sense the momentum turning here. It's first and 10.
First and 10 at the 16-yard line.
Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes. And that'll be complete to Dobbins. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. They'll contain him to just 4, second down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Mahomes going to keep this himself. On the RPO, that's complete right side. And here he'll get it down to the 7. It's a gain of 5, and that'll make it 3rd and 1.
A gain of 5. Brings up 3rd and 1.
They'll try and run for the first with Edwards. And he gets the first down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the 6. Just a gain of 1 yard, but it's going to set him up with a 1st and goal.
The 6-yard line.
Now Mahomes. They'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. A great play there with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Ravens have retaken the lead. And this is no good. It's a missed extra point. Boy, in a tight game, how important might that turn out to be here as the second half rolls along? Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Bengals drive about to get going. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter 3, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. On first down, it's Jones. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here.
The ball carrier.
It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down.
A gain of 4. It's now 2nd and 6.
Burrow will throw. He'll drop this underneath for Jones. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 12 yards there and a 1st down.
A gain of 12. 1st down, Bengals.
They're passing here, Joe Burrow. This into the hands of his running back, Ronald Jones. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Another connection between the two. This one good for 12 and a first down.
First down.
Now Burrow. He'll find Jones again. Complete. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
A 3-yard pickup brings up second and 7 at the Ravens' 34-yard line.
And Burrow going to throw again. Man open, that's Robert Foster complete. And he is out of bounds inside the 30.
I know we just saw a nice throwing catch, but how about the big guys up front buying that time? Yeah, that's exactly what they did. They created time and allowed the space to happen, and it turned into a really nice play.
And he gets the first down here as he's taken down at the 24. They're able to convert with a gain of 4.
A 4-yard pickup on the play. First down, Cincinnati.
They'll run on first down. Mixon. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21.
Joe Mixon, the Bengal ball.
Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
It's a pickup of 3. Brings up 2nd and 7.
1 quarter remains here as we wrap up the week on a Monday night. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. On 2nd down, here's Burrow. He gets this in the hands of Mixon. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8. That last play, backwards a yard.
3rd down.
Out of the huddle now for play number 9 on this drive. This is 3rd down and 8. Here's Burrow. Got an open man, that's Campbell. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward. Down left side on the swing pass. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. 7 yards there on the first down screen play. From the 6 now on 2nd and 3. From the shotgun, a give to Jones. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. A 5-yard gain there makes it 1st and goal.
Some good strong running right there. Some power and some explosiveness just about got him into the end zone.
And the question now, how do they want to work the clock here on 1st and goal? A field goal would give them the late lead. Mixon trying to punch it in. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the 2. Nothing doing there as the 13th play of the drive proves to be unlucky. Here's a run with Mixon. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And that's going to bring up an interesting 3rd and goal. Here's Mixon. And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. Not at all what they envisioned on 3rd down. 3 yards in the wrong direction. So on 4th down, trots the kicker in a big spot here. This for a 4th quarter lead.
This is up and good from Pinheiro.
And with that, they have taken the lead by a point here in the fourth.
16.
So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it and happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown and seal this thing?
Up to midfield. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. Look at him go inside the 30. And he won't get all the way into the end zone as he's out of bounds, but not before getting it down inside the 10. And the question now, how do they want to work the clock here on first and goal? A field goal would give them the late lead. They'll try the option on first and goal. Mahomes quickly complete out wide. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. That catch good for only a couple.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs. And they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
That's complete right around the 8. And he's brought down right at the 5-yard line. Give him 2 on the play. Only able to pick up 2, and that leads us to 3rd and goal. They'll try to run with Dobbins. And he is marked down right about on top of that imaginary yellow line, but they say he's a bit short. 4 yards, that gets him close to the goal line, but it also brings up a 4th and goal. Fourth quarter, 2 minutes on the clock in a tight 1-point game. So it's Raven football here as we welcome you back. They come up on the play of the game now, 4th and goal. And they'll try to run it in with Dobbins. They'll try and run it here. And he will get into the end zone to extend the lead by 2 more.
Ravens 24, Bengals 17.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return.
The Bengals take over first and 10 at their own 31-yard line.
The Bengals drive about to get going. And they had a long drive last time, but they had to settle for a field goal. And I'm sure that's how it felt to them, settling. They probably should have gotten in the end zone.
Yeah, not out and out joy, right? Because that's what you get when you put the ball in the end zone. But there are benefits to that type of a long drive. Your defense gets a chance to take a break, adjust a little bit, maybe get themselves ready to get back out on the field and play a little bit better. So they'll take the benefit, even though
this is caught inside the 15. And all of a sudden, they're knocking on the door inside Baltimore's 10.
First and goal at the 9-yard line.
Yeah. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And yes, he's into the end zone. So they get the late score they needed. And now the extra point can tie this thing up in the final minute.
And while it appears the heavy lifting was accomplished by scoring the touchdown, they're still down one. That extra point is not a gimme.
24. Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And we are tied here in the fourth quarter. Nothing separating these two sides. 24 all our score as he sends this one away. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much as he's marked down officially at the 21.
At their own 21-yard line.
Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They, of course, tie game, would like to avoid overtime if they could.
And a lot of people would go ahead and play it safe here and get to overtime and try and win it there. But you know, sitting up here in the booth, let's go for this thing, try and push it, and maybe catch the defense back on their heels a bit.
See if they do that.
At the 36-yard line.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Mahomes to throw. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and 3.
Brings up second.
To throw is Mahomes. Flush to his right. On the crossing route, complete. That's Brown. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
At the 39-yard line.
It out quickly, and it's complete out wide. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in the game. Second down and 8. Option play on second down. Here's a quick throw right side, and it's complete. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 11 yards there, first down.
First and 10 at the 26-yard line.
Now Mahomes. And this is going to be intercepted. Switch.
We're in the fourth quarter and it's a tie game. You've got to take care of the football here. Now their opportunity to take the lead right out the window, and everything is flipped in the other direction.
He'll find his running back, Joe Mixon. Now a final chance to stop it here as a timeout comes in with 10 seconds left in the game.
It's a gain of 7. Brings up 2nd and 3 at the 38-yard line.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. 2nd and 3. Now it's Burrow. The left side completion to Jones. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. And a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining. So it'll all come down to the right foot of Eddie Pinheiro. This from long, very long range. That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short. No good. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It'll be their second and final timeout, remember, here in overtime. We'll be back. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
Drive about to get going. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win it.
And I think teams around the league are still adjusting to the idea of going downfield, scoring a touchdown wins the game, because they were used to just going downfield and trying to get in field goal range to win a game. Still having to make that transition. Let's face it now, the ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
Yeah, as we said, they control their own destiny now.
And it's third down.
Third and one, trying to keep this drive and overtime going. A big one coming up. They give to Mixon to try to pick it up. And he will have a first down here at about the 40.
Joe Mixon.
An effective 7-yard third down conversion.
A gain of 7. And the Bengals first down.
On first down, it's Jones. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. It's a gain of 13, and the Bengals have a first down. They go with the ground game, pick up the first, now in plus territory.
And that changes the whole mentality of a play caller, doesn't it? Once they cross the 50, they feel like they're in the strike zone, all right? You don't have to be in the red zone to take those big shots downfield or go after the end zone. Right now, that might be available to him.
And now his first drive in OT continues. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
Bengals.
Burrow going to give this to Mixon. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Tackle made by Tyus Bowser. And now the Ravens are going to take another timeout. They'll be left with just one remaining here at OT. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. He finds his running back, Mixon. They'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4. 2 minutes left in this overtime session, and still all tied. It's 3rd and 4. Big play here, trying to keep this opening drive of overtime alive. From the shotgun, it's Burrow. And he finds Howard complete. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. They stop him for only 3 that time, and that'll bring up 4th down. So a big move here, playing to win in overtime. They're going to go for it on 4th down. Down to 2, and we get a signal and a timeout. They'll be down to just 1 remaining as we step aside here in overtime.
A big one coming for kicker Eddie Pinheiro.
This to at least get him a lead here in overtime. The kick by Pinheiro is good. And the Bengals are on the board first here. It's 3-0. They're able to put three on the board here on the opening drive of OT, and now up to their defense to try and see if they can hold this one.
I like how you framed it up, because obviously this game is not over, right? They go down and kick a field goal. Then we head to second down. But the defense can hold it. Take the ball away. Turn it over on downs. This game's over.
At their own 23-yard line.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. The field goal would push it to sudden death. We just saw the field goal on the other end, but I don't think they are thinking field goal. At least not to start this drive, they're not thinking field goal.
Not at all, because your point is well taken. Yeah, kick the field goal, you push it to sudden death. But you're also kicking off and giving the other team the ball with a chance to kick a field goal and beat you. Get the touchdown, finish the game off. That has to be the mindset.
Mahomes now on first down. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout. That's their second and last timeout here in the overtime session. We'll be back. Looking to throw on second down. Mahomes. Oh, a scramble for the football, and he's going to come down with it. Take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 15 yards on the play, first down.
At the 49-yard line.
Mahomes gonna throw. Flushed out right. Now he'll let it go deep right side. Oh, if he holds on, it's game over. Instead, second down.
Ray certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. The Bengal pressure gets him that time. Down he goes. The former number three pick, Joey Bosa, bringing the lumber that time. He's going deep for Brown. And that will be incomplete. They weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. A partner, a great game that we got to see, and making it extra special. Not only did I get four quarters with you in this one, I got some overtime, a little whipped cream on top.
Look at you, trying to make this whole thing palatable.
I just want you to pay for my meal later.
You really just wanted four quarters, what you wanted. But how much fun was that? We had that type of a game where we got us to overtime, and then we get the dramatic ending to finish things off as well. What a game.
So for the Bengals, it was a great all-around performance as they come out of this one with the victory. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to Jacksonville to take on the Jaguars. Meanwhile, for Baltimore, they'll fall to 1-1. And they'll try to rebound next week as they head to Heinz Field to take on the Steelers. That'll do it for us. I'm Brandon Gauden alongside Charles Davis. Thanks to our entire crew as well. We'll talk to you next time. So long, everybody.